Hello my dear friends, welcome back to the channel, and this is your friend Dr. Suresh Shenvi. From many days, students have been requesting me to make video on impression materials, and that's why I am starting with the new series on impression material, and today we'll be covering the alginate. It all started in Scotland, where a chemist found this brown seaweed algae, which is very commonly found in oceans, and he extracted the algin from this algae. And they soon found out that algin has very good medicinal properties, like its ability to reduce the cholesterol. It is also used to treat the wound, and it is also used to treat the cough. But it was in England when the S. William found that this algin can also be used as an impression material, and he patented it for the dental use for the first time. But alginate only became popular during World War II, because during this time the popular impression material named agar had a very limited supply. And soon this elastic irreversible hydrophilic alginate became very popular because it was very easy to manipulate, it was comfortable to the patient, and it was the most economic impression material of all the impression material available even today. Now let's learn about the chemistry of alginate. Alginate is a type of hydrocolloid, and in simple terms, the hydrocolloid is a substance which forms a gel in the presence of water. But alginate is an irreversible hydrocolloid, whereas the agar, which we'll discuss in the next video, is a reversible hydrocolloid. Chemically, alginate is a polymer which, when mixed with water, gives you a sol, and the sol converts to a gel, and this process of converting a sol to gel gives us the impression, and this step is called as gelation. But as mentioned earlier, this gelation process in alginate is irreversible, in contrast to the agar, where it is reversible. At a microstructure, you will realize it is the micelles of alginate which forms a brush heap structure when it converts from a sol to the gel form. But there is a problem. This alginic acid is non-soluble in nature, and in order to make this alginic acid soluble, we always use the alginic acid in its salt form. And generally, it will be either sodium or potassium form of alginate. And that's why the composition usually says that it is potassium alginate, which makes it soluble in water. Now, in order to convert this sol into a gel, we need a reactor. And this reactor is basically calcium sulfate. And this calcium sulfate, which is a reactor, supplies calcium to the potassium alginate, which converts the potassium alginate to calcium alginate, which is a final gel product of alginate, which is non-soluble. This reactor is very easy to remember because we use it very often in the form of gypsum, plaster of Paris, which is basically calcium sulfate, hemihydrate or dihydrate. Now, there is still another problem with this reaction. If you want to use this material clinically, the reaction continues so fast that you may not find sufficient working time. So, in order to delay the setting, a third component is added, and we term it as retarder for the alginate. And this is commonly either sodium phosphate or sodium triphosphate or tetrasodium pyrophosphate. And this reaction is very simple. The calcium sulfate will first react with this retarder, and unless this retarder is completely used, the calcium sulfate will not react with the potassium alginate, giving us good amount of working time. Apart from this, a filler named diatomaceous earth is also added, which makes the impression material strong. It gives us a less sticky mixture of the impression, making it comfortable to the patient. But in spite of all this, there is still another problem. And the problem happens when you pour the impression of alginate. The potassium alginate retards the setting of the gypsum. And that's why, in order to accelerate the setting of the stone, another component, that is either titanium fluoride or potassium sulfate, is added to the alginate because it increases the setting of stone. And please note, this is where the students go wrong, because they think this accelerator is for the alginate, but it is for the dental stone. And this is a very common question in your MCQ exam. So the final structure of set alginate consists of brush heap of calcium alginate fibril network, enclosing sodium alginate sol, and around 80% of water along with the filler particles. Now let's learn the property of the alginate impression material. Depending on the setting time, we get two types of alginate impression material, and they are usually divided into fast set and regular set. And as the name indicates, the working, mixing and setting time is less in fast set compared to the regular set. And the details are given in this slide. Please note that these timings are only applicable when you mix the alginate at room temperature. The second property is wettability, which is very good with the alginate, indicating that if you use this material and the area of impression has some amount of water, the impression will be recorded properly in spite of presence of water. That's possible because the alginate and agar are both hydrocolloids, which are inherently hydrophilic in nature. And the next important property is the flexibility. The alginate has one of the highest flexibility, that is 14%. And you may ask me, what is the use of this flexibility? Suppose you are taking an impression which has a lot of undercut, and once the impression sets, it is easier to remove the impression from this undercut area without breaking the impression. The next important property is the tear strength. Suppose you are recording a very thin area where there is very little amount of alginate has reached. While pulling it from this thin area, this impression material will break very easily because of the low tear strength. The next very important property is its accuracy, that is its ability to replicate the surface details. And as per American Dental Association, a hydrocolloid impression material should reproduce a line which is as thin as 0.075 millimeter. Unfortunately, the alginate doesn't fit this category. And that's why alginate impression is not good for making impression from the preparation which is meant for fixed restorations like crowns and bridges, because they will not be able to replicate the thin margins which is prepared on the tooth structure. The next important property for the impression material is the dimensional stability. Unfortunately, alginate is not dimensionally stable, and that's why you should pour it as soon as possible. And since the alginate has a lot amount of water in its structure, it can absorb water if you keep the impression under water or moist, and this property is called as imbibition. Or it may also lose water from its material, and that is called as syneresis, making it shrink. And this also means that you cannot send the impression to the lab without pouring, which is possible in the impression material called as adhesion silicone, because that has dimensional stability for days, which allows us to send the impression directly to the lab without pouring it. And also note that unused alginate powder should be always stored in a cool, dry place. Otherwise, it will depolymerize and it won't set when it is used the next time. The next segment is, how is the alginate available in the market? That is the mode of supply. Usually, we commonly buy the alginate powder in bulk packs, although small packs are also available, which you have to mix with water to make the impression. There is also sol state available of alginate, which is devoid of any calcium, and that's why it won't set unless you add some amount of gypsum powder, which will convert the sol to gel because of addition of the calcium from the gypsum particles. You also have two tube system of the alginate impression material, in which the first tube will contain the alginate and the second tube will contain the calcium. Now let's talk about the manipulation of alginate. Most commonly, we use the scoop and the measurement jar which is given in the packet to proportionate the alginate powder. But as per the textbook, the alginate powder should be weighed before using it in order to get the exact proportion. But clinically, unless you end up changing the water powder ratio more than 15%, the effect is very minimal. And the ideal powder liquid ratio for alginate impression material is 15 gram of powder with 40 ml of water. And it is important that you use a clean rubber bowl and spatula. That is because any remaining gypsum gypsum powder in the bowl will accelerate the setting of alginate. As you all know that we use figure of 8 motion for mixing the alginate impression material and then we use a perforated tray. Please note that there should be at least 3 mm of thickness of alginate impression material between the teeth and the impression tray, without which the impression will be very weak. Also, you should always remove the impression within 2 to 3 minutes because the research says if it is removed more than 3 minutes later, then it is found to reduce the strength of the impression. Also note, you should not remove the impression very slowly from the teeth because this will increase the permanent deformation of the impression. If you want to delay the pouring of the impression, which is ideally not recommended, but in that case, you should always keep it at 100% humidity. And as soon as you pour it, you should always wait for 60 minutes before separating the impression material from the cast. Exams do ask you about the disinfection of the alginate impression, and the textbooks recommend glutaraldehyde or sodium hypochlorite for 10 minutes for complete disinfection without affecting the property of the alginate impression. Now let's talk about the last section, which is very commonly asked in your exam, is the modifications of alginate impression material. The first modification was the introduction of dustless alginate. As the impression materials contain around 60% of the filler, that is diatomaceous earth, this can cause a respiratory hazard because of its small particle size. In order to reduce that, a de-dusting agent called as glycol is added to the alginate powder, which agglomerates the alginate powder, making it less prone for dusting. The second modification of alginate, which is commonly preferred by the practitioner, is the color changing alginate powder, which can help us to judge the setting of the impression material better. And these are based on the pH or the acid base indicator into the composition. And the last recent modification is the introduction of the alginate with a high accuracy and a 5 days dimensional stability as claimed by the manufacturer. If you like the video, click the like button, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon. If you have any questions, please mention into the comment section and I will see you once again very soon with a new video on Aspire 32.